Welcome students. Today we see about the topic point defects. In the previous class itself, we discussed about imperfections in solids. In this topic, we see about line defects, point defects, etc. And this the main defect is point defect one. The point defect is classified into three types. That is stoichiometric, and then non-stoichiometric. And then impurity defects. Okay, the name itself denotes that stoichiometric means balanced defects, and the non-stoichiometric means non-balanced defects, and then impurity defects means just you are adding an impurity to the substance. Okay, first of all, stoichiometric. Stoichiometric is also called as an instinctive defects, which is also called as an thermodynamic defect. Okay, stoichiometric defects is also called as an instinctive defects or thermodynamic defects. In this stoichiometric defects, how will it occur? By missing equal numbers, by missing equal number of positive and then its opposite charges negative ions, equal number of missing of positive and then negative ions. And then it can also occur their ions are not present in or not present in lattice points. Okay, point defects are occur mainly on this two only. Okay, by missing equal number of positive or negative ions, their ions are not present in the lattice points. Okay, if it is not present in lattice point, mean just imagine this, consider it is a lattice point. Okay, first one positive ions, this is negative ions, this is positive ions, this is negative ions. If positive ions are missing, if positive ions are missing, equal number of negative ions also are missing. Okay, one positive ions are missing and then one equal number of negative ions also missing. So another way, there is no missing. Okay, the positive ions or negative ions are present in the interstitial positions. Interstitial positions means between the two lattice points there is a space, no? That space is called as an interstitial position. In this interstitial positions, the ions are present. Okay. So now we have seen that equal number of positive and the negative ions. So equal number of positive and the negative ions. So there will be a balanced one. So it is called as an stoichiometric defects. Okay. So now you can see about there are two types of stoichiometric defects. First, Schottky defect, Schottky defect, and then Frenkel defects. Schottky defect and then Frenkel defects. We already told, no, stoichiometric defects, that is balanced defects, which will occur only in the two types, two ways. First, missing of equal number of ions, we told, no, that is positive and the negative ions, like that. Here you saw one positive ion is missing and then one negative ion is missing. So equal number of positive and then negative ions is missing. So this atom, this crystal will be a neutral one because they are electrically neutral. Positive ions and the negative ions are both are equal. So they are electrically neutral. So, and then they have similar in size. The cations and then anions are similar in size, first point. And then second, their density will be less compared to the parent one. Okay. First, if you imagine it is an NaCl crystal, in the NaCl crystal, here a positive charge and then here negative charge. If Schottky effect is occur in a NaCl crystal, this positive ions and negative ions are missing. So, their density is will be less than the parent one. And then, next, equal number of missing of positive and then negative ions. Positive and then negative ions. You see, one positive ions is missing and then negative ions also missed by one. Okay, it is called as an Schottky defects. Example, NaCl. Okay, and then next, Frenkel defects. The Frenkel defects, we told stoichiometric defects is always occurred only in two ways. One, equal number of missing of ions, positive and negative ions, and then another one is just the ions are present in the interstitial positions. We told, no? Just you see. Here the positive ions is missing, okay, the positive ions is missed from its original position, that is lattice point, and it is placed in a interstitial position, okay. It can also told that dislocation of ions, okay, we can told it is as interstitial position or dislocation of ions. So dislocation of ions occur only in the Frenkel defects. It is example, silver bromide, silver chloride, etc. Here, it told in Schottky defects similar in size, but in Frenkel defects the positive ions will be small in size and the negative ions will be larger in size. So there will be a size vary. Anions are larger in size than cation. Okay, in Schottky defects we told that there is a similar size, but in Frenkel defects anions are larger in size than cations. And then second point, there is no change in density. Density, no change. Here you see Schottky defects density will be less than the parent one. But in Frenkel defects, density will be no change because the positive ions is located in the interstitial positions. So density will be no changed. Okay. And then third point, in the Frenkel defects, the examples are mainly transition elements, that is silver chloride, silver bromide, cadmium chloride, etc. Okay. Hope you understand. Schottky and then Frenkel. Now, non-stoichiometric defects. Yes, students. Non-stoichiometric defects mainly classified into two types. Non-stoichiometric, name itself it denotes it is a non-balanced one. Here, there are two types of defects. One it is metal excess and then metal deficiency defects. Metal deficiency defects. Metal excess defects. Metal excess defects. The name itself denotes easily metal excess. That's a positive ions will be higher than the negative ions. Okay. The positive ions will be always smaller in size and the negative ions will be larger in size. So just you imagine. consider it is a sodium chloride crystal. If you are heating this sodium chloride crystal with sodium vapor, if you are heating sodium vapor, just you see, if you are heating sodium, it converts into sodium ions and gives one electron. Okay, it converts into sodium ions and give one electrons. If you are heating means here the negative ions is present, no, that is chloride ions, that is chloride ions, this is Cl. Here it is sodium. Okay, so in the sodium chloride crystals, if you are heating with sodium vapor, the positive Na plus ions is just placed on it. Okay, placed on the surface of this crystal, which attracts the negative ions, that is chloride ions. So it easily converts into sodium chloride. Okay, the positive ions which attract the negative ions, chloride ions, and it converts into sodium chloride crystals. Okay, so there will be a hole. Okay, there will be a hole or a vacant place. In this vacant place, the electrons get placed. Okay, the electrons are get placed, which is called as an F center. In the anionic position, the electrons are placed, no, which is called as an F centers. Here you see chloride ions X and then sodium ions X. Here one sodium ions is X is no, so 1 plus X. The formula can be written as 1 plus X Cl. Okay, simply. Okay, and we can also give an example for this is with zinc oxide. Zinc oxide is also an example for metal excess defects. Consider zinc oxide. It is zinc. This is oxide, zinc oxide. If you are heating zinc oxide, first zinc oxide is colorless one. First it is a colorless one. When it is heated, it turns into yellow color. How it turns into yellow color means, if you are heating zinc oxide means the oxide ions present in this is just escapes out. Just imagine that this oxide ions is get escape. So here you see zinc is excess than the oxide ions. Okay, so it is called as an metal excess defects. Okay, so hope you understand with this two examples. Now you see about metal deficiency defects. Metal deficiency defects. See the name, metal deficiency defects. Metal will be deficient one. So here metal, that is positive ions, will be less than the negative ions. Example, ferric oxide or ferric chloride, etc. We can simply say transition metals oxide can be used as an example for metal deficiency defects. Because why you are choosing transition metal oxides means the transition metal has variable oxidation state. Okay, variable oxidation state, that is Fe has two types of oxidation states. One it is Fe2 plus, and then another it is Fe3 plus. Okay, Fe2 plus and then Fe3 plus. Okay, so we are choosing transition metal oxide as an examples. So it is ion, it is oxide. Okay, the bigger in size is an oxide and then smaller size is oxide. Here ion which is present in plus 2 oxidation state. Okay, so we know that oxide which is O2 minus. Here the missing of Fe ions can take place. Missing of Fe ions can take place. Here Fe ions is missing. So if you are missed by Fe ions is missed means here Fe2 plus ions is present, no? Here, 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 and here. Which can takes one charge additional, then its original charges. Okay, its original charge we told, no, Fe2 plus, instead of it changes into Fe3 plus. It takes one additional charge, that is Fe3 plus. So if it takes Fe3 plus and if it also take place Fe3 plus, here one positive ions is increased, here also one positive ions is increased, which is balanced its missing ions. Okay. So this oxide ions is balanced by, counterbalanced by Fe2 plus. Instead of Fe2 plus, here it changes into Fe3 plus, here also changes into Fe3 plus. So here one positive ions, here one positive ions. So here itself we have 2 plus. So it is compensated by nearby oxide ions. Okay. So just it is compensated by this present Fe2 plus ions. Okay. Fe2 plus ions charges is changes into Fe3 plus ions. Okay, Fe3 plus ions, just one additional charges is gained by Fe ions. Okay, so that only we choose the transition metal oxide as examples. Okay, so we can also Fe zinc oxide etc. Transition metals always as used as an metal deficiency. Hope you understand stoichiometric and then non-stoichiometric, and the last is impurity defects. Impurity defects, the name itself, it denotes that if you are having silver chloride crystal, silver chloride crystal, silver, this is also silver chloride crystal. Okay, if you are adding an impurities, here you are adding an impurities, cadmium chloride. Okay, you know that the charges of silver chloride is plus 1 and then this is minus 1. If you are adding an impurity cadmium chloride, that is charges is, this is 2 plus. Okay, if you are adding an impurity cadmium chloride to silver chloride crystals, first this cadmium displaces one silver ion. Okay, cadmium is present here. Just here you know Ag plus is leaving out from its lattice point, just only one plus ion is missing. But you know cadmium has 2 plus charge. So there it will create another silver ions to pull out, to escape out from this original points. Okay, now you add this Ag plus 1, Ag plus 1. So two charges are going out. Okay. Instead of its cadmium chloride, Cd2 plus is present here. Here the holes are created, so there will be electrons present in this. So electrons will be move around this. So it will be electrically, it conducts electricity. Okay, hope you understand impurity defects. Thank you, students. Oh, wow.